Check 1, 2, testing 1, 2. So what we have here today is an AKG C414 microphone. This is the XLS model. And as you can hear in the background, it's a bit noisy. We've got some problems. So we're going to clean it. And I'm going to show you how I do it. All right, let's get started. So here's what we're going to need for tools and supplies to clean this microphone. The first thing I've got here is a package of gloves. These are nitrile gloves because in most microphones like this, there is a super high impedance section right under the capsule. That's the first section of the circuit, and the impedance is so high that you cannot touch it and leave any kind of oil deposits from your skin on it, because that will affect the capacitance. Which can lead to, again, problems of noise and such. So we're going to wear rubber gloves, or these nitrile rubber gloves. And the next thing we have here is three different solutions. This is distilled water mixed with 99% isopropyl alcohol. The alcohol itself is 99%. So the mixture, there's three different ratios here. On the first one, I've mixed it 25% alcohol to 75% water. And on the second one, 10% alcohol. The third one, distilled water only. And what the idea is we have three different artist brushes here. These are sable brushes, very, very soft. And we'll have one brush for each solution. The first solution, being the strongest with the 25% alcohol, will be the first one to go on cleaning the diaphragm. And then we progress to number two, which is the 10% solution, and then finally clean it up with the pure distilled water. Next thing we have is just the screwdriver. It looks like a Phillips screwdriver is all that's necessary for this AKG C414. So let's get started. All right, there are three screws that hold the chassis of this mic together, one here at the XLR and two for the body. I've removed them, and now I can just slide the body out, and that exposes the electronics section. All right, now to disassemble this, the first thing we do is we pop this selector switch, and to do that, I press down on it and kind of fold it out, like so. It's just a piece of plastic. Now this allows me to take the amplifier board out. So as you can see, this is held in just a pressure fit with some connectors, some pin connectors. We'll put that aside. Now I can take the roll off and pad switches, and we pull them out, and that allows me to get this board out, like so. There we have our capsule. This board that we're looking at here, this is the high impedance board. This is the one you definitely do not want to contaminate with your skin oil. So I'm just going to leave that in there, and we'll get to it. Okay, here we can get a good look at the kind of debris that's on this membrane. It's pretty dirty, and so is the other side. Now I'm also looking at, looks like a slight, either a puncture right here in the at about 4 o'clock, I can see a little bit of a puncture or something on the membrane. So we're going to have to be careful around that. But you can see this black debris is all over this the white part as well. So we're going to try and clean everything up. All right, so we're going to start with solution number one. And what we're doing is applying almost no pressure, just swirling that solution on the membrane. I can see the debris moving around, that's good. Again, we apply no pressure. We just let the weight of the bristles really do the work. Last thing you want to do is push down on this. Right, so we rinse that, and now we move on to our second brush, and the number two solution. We just keep swirling that around until all of the debris is loosened and you can see that it's moving around. There, I was able to pick some a big chunk of dirt up. All right, it looks to be pretty loosened now. Now we're going to go on to our third brush, which is just the distilled water. You can see on the tip of that white brush that there's quite a bit of that black crap. I suspect that a lot of it is the debris from the deteriorating rubber, perhaps the suspension mount, but that in combination with spit and grunge is what makes the capsule noisy. So now, instead of rinsing this brush in my number three, which is the pure distilled water, I'm going to rinse this in number one, just so I don't contaminate my number three. And now, I'm going to use this can of compressed air, and I'm going to blow out the bristles and dry them. So I've cycled that procedure a few times now, and looks like I've got pretty much all of the debris. And one last time, I'm going to just clean it up with the pure distilled water and maybe cycle through this a couple of times. We want to get rid of any traces of the number one or two solutions. We don't want to leave the film of the alcohol on there. And I was wrong about that puncture at the 4 o'clock location. It was just a piece of debris. So that's good. All right. So that looks good. We're going to clean this off in solution number 2. And then once again in solution number 3. And blow it dry. And then pick up that water and get rid of it. I know I shouldn't have to say this, but it might sound like it makes sense to dry the actual capsule membrane with your compressed air, but don't do that. And there we are. That one is clean. On to the other side. Same procedure. So I've done the same for the other side, and it turned out very well. Nice and clean. So now we're going to go on to tackling all of the other areas. And that includes these little green wires. We're going to get all this stuff, even the brass ring around the Mylar. Gonna get rid of the crap on that. For cleaning all other areas that are not the actual membrane, I'm just gonna go ahead and use cotton swabs. So same idea, we cycle through the different solutions until we end up with just a distilled water, and that side will be done. All right, so I've cleaned up all of the area around the capsule inside of the head basket with a Q-tip, and I went through the stages, the different solutions 1, 2, and 3, and now I'm going to just carefully clean it up with my last brush. And what I'm really looking for here now is fibers. I want to get rid of any of the fibers that the cotton swab may have left behind, because those can cause you problems if you have a fiber that's, you know, coming from the lead here and tickling the membrane, that kind of thing. So generally I work with some magnifying lenses. I've got them on right now, and they're great to be able to see really close up, because sometimes those fibers are really small. I think this side is pretty much good to go, and we can do the same to the other side. All right, so the capsule and the head basket area is all nice and clean. Now we're going to take a look at cleaning the high impedance board. That's this one here. I'm going to do this with our number 1 paintbrush, number 1 solution. This is an area really where you don't want to use a Q-tip, a cotton swab, because there's so many things for the fibers to get snagged on here. And as I said, because it's such a high impedance board, if that fiber is dangling around and it's got any kind of conductive oil or whatever on it, it's going to cause problems. Now we're going to clean the gold contact pins as well, and we're going to use contact cleaner. The stuff that I like is MG Chemicals Super Contact Cleaner, because it's great on gold surfaces. Here I am going to use a Q-tip though, and just gently just just gently apply it like this. Outward strokes. As I said, we don't want to leave any fibers. But I do have my magnifying and inspection glasses, and I'll be looking this over very carefully to make sure that we have left no fibers. Before I put the head basket back together, I blew out the grills with my compressed air, and you may be able to see on camera, they're both dented in a little bit, so I'm going to take this opportunity now to just reform them. Really easy to just push them around, get that dent out. Yeah, that looks pretty good, that one. And that looks good as well. Now when putting these back together, there's a little index pin on each side of the head basket inside. And that's where we pin the grill. So it goes in like this. We need to slide these out a little so that, there we go. And same thing on this side. Yeah, there we go. Alright, so that's our head basket back together again. The last thing we'll do is we'll clean up these remaining boards, at least the pins anyway, the connecting pins, and back to our MG Chemicals contact cleaner. This is our ground to chassis connection. And we might as well go ahead and do the XLR pins at this time as well. Alright, we're good to go. Just reassemble it. So first we install the amplifier board, but in order to do that we have to create a bit of clearance. So we push the high impedance board out, and actually the grill comes with it a little bit. And this just allows us to get in there and make that connection. Go, and we can close it back down. Now we can go to the other side and connect this board. So there's two connectors. We have to engage the connector that goes this way and then down into the amplifier board, like so. Now we just pop the switch back in. So again, it was rolled out, so we're going to roll it back in. Like so. There we go. And finally, screw the chassis back together. And that's it. We want to wait, just for good measure, I would wait a day, or at least half a day, for any trace of that moisture on the capsule to dry out before I plug it in and test it out. All right, that's my method for cleaning a large diaphragm microphone that's so gunked up that it's making noise. I wouldn't recommend doing this on a regular basis, only when it really actually has to happen, because it's just too noisy and there's just too much stuff, too much gunk on there. It's the same method I used for other large diaphragm microphones, for example, U87s, Neumann U87s. I've cleaned successfully this way, and I think it sounds pretty clean as compared to before. Let's just take a listen to the noise floor. Yeah, you can hear my computer fan in the background, and I think the fridge in the next room, but other than that, the actual the noise floor of the mic itself seems to be very good now.
Hope that helps somebody. Thanks for watching.